Just like that, we are getting into the last day of January. Yes, can I hear someone say amen? Finally, if you haven't received your salary by now, it's okay to walk into your boss's office and talk to them and tell them, boss, please, to yambi. But good morning to you. Good morning, everyone who's joining us for yet another beautiful episode of Urban Today. Time to give you a smile, laughter, and the reason as why you need to go look for that money. I'm not alone. I am with the beautiful Tina Fias and, of course, the man from the East, Willis Daly. Good morning to you, Tina and Willis.
Well, he wanted you to say, well, the man from the East, the beast from the East, but no.
No, you see...
You don't come close to anything this
way. We're from...
Has he ever intimidated you?
No.
We, the rich people, do not have to intimidate poor people. You understand? We just live our lives comfortably and, you know, you understand? We live to see tomorrow. Unlike you who celebrates the last day of the month only. For us, we celebrate every day because anyway, we
make money. The money's there.
It's there. Mm. But you see, the reason why you people like you need to celebrate the last day of the month is also because that the moon, you know, is going to come out, not because of a salary. And please don't go attacking your bosses and, you know, telling them to pay you in time and whatnot. No, if your boss wants to pay you, they'll pay you. And if they don't want to pay you...
So for you, you had attack.
Yeah,
you had attack.
What did you say? What did you say?
You had attack.
This is what I had.
You did not see the opportunity of just meeting the boss.
For what?
So, of course, such people miss out on opportunities.
What do you mean?
Like that.
What do you see? What do you mean?
Guys,
somebody help Kulina, my friend.
What do you mean meeting the bosses? I meet my bosses. And...
I will not be dealing with the back and forth between the two of you like kanukawa wala kawa wala na wawa wala kugamba mba kuseti ngo mtuwe gunuma. Anyway, continue.
Catherine says, "Chichi, what is happening this morning?" What is that? You're using very wrong
words to describe people
that are important in this movement of ours.
Why is it like a rolled up mattress?
Katujukire ebiseera ebyo bye twatambulanga okuva ewaka paka ku ssomero ne tulinnya takisi ne batutuuza ku bumeme
naye
abaana b'ennaku zino
They
walk, but kameme.
We deliberately eat our money and transport. Sit on the kameme. At times it would burn your car behind. At times under your car thigh. But it was.
No, it would get so hot, and you hold yourself on the right and left and sit
and
like.
And you'd be like,
Nova Kubuganda road. Not they come out.
That was so sweet. I missed out that experience too,
No, you were. For you, were in the village. They gave you a bicycle, man. You got Uber.
And you're like, Daddy, the AC is too much. Like, and then they reduce the AC for you.
This guy reminds me of the same guys he was talking about when graduation hit.
No.
Chapa, first of all.
No.
Yamitanga.
Chapa, where? You realize that all those good schools around Mbara High School and all those good schools around Ntare, whenever someone comes from such a school, they claim that they are from either Ntare or Chapa.
I know, right?
Kumbe they are from neighboring schools.
Tiny,
those schools around Mwiri. All those who secondary schools around.
I didn't get an education.
Keep quiet.
No, I didn't get an education.
You say you are
alive? Yes.
Are you sure you are
alive? Yeah, Iroa.
There is no line that looks like this.
Iroa! No, you can ask the president. It's my OB.
You do what?
You ask the president. It's my OB.
Is it?
We don't need to add you.
Which president?
Of Uganda, and Rwanda.
He just says it just for Katase.
No.
But look at the bull.
Hold on. For what?
Katase.
Katase.
Guys, can we get the show on the road? All of you who are waking up with us today morning, it's quite simple. Join the conversation. Be a part of this conversation. Quite simple. At TinaFiasOne, at Willis Daly, and at Urban Daly on Twitter and every Urban TV platform. That's Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, anywhere. We're all there for today, though. I'm excited about today.
Let me ask, have the prices of transport reduced since Christmas?
Yeah, of course, they dropped.
They're back to normal.
Yeah, like our inflation,
back to normal.
Our prices for fuel and our prices for transportation are like inflation after or before we get into an election.
But the price of fuel got down.
I don't know, fuel. I feel like Ugandans no longer have time to argue about fuel.
Why?
Oh, they do.
Prices will go up. I do not. They will argue for 2 days, 3 days, but then that's it.
And then they
have no option. You will either park your car or go to the petrol station, despite the fact that the fuel is at 5K or 7K.
Do you know how we argue when the fuel prices go up? When you go to the pump and the fuel prices are up, you start telling the guy, clean my windshield.
Like you're getting your
money. I want my money. Until that mama ziga wiper.
Sooner or later, you'll start demanding for the car to be washed. Scrub those tires.
But when the fuel prices are low, you just spark, bye, thank you, sweet.
And you are.
And you
go. Let's get into shout outs this morning. And of course, mine are going to the Ministry of Works and Transport. They have taken an initiative upon themselves to actually do register all boats and vessels on Lake Victoria. Now, we all know one of the biggest calamities that did happen last year regarding the boat cruise. Now, after that, the Ministry of Works and Transport has taken this main step to actually get to find out how many boats do operate on Lake Victoria, how many vessels are there. And they're saying they will do this each day starting yesterday until they get to find out a couple of boats that actually do operate. But remember that there has been some resistance coming in from certain individuals on Lake Victoria for them coming out to say that they didn't know about this operation, and they think that if the government actually comes up to still go ahead with this, they may get displaced. But of course, an official right there, as you can see in that picture, came out and explained to them and said that this registration has nothing to do with you being displaced from your places. All they need to do is find out how to plan for these boats and even improve on the service delivery along Lake Victoria. So we do hope that this can manage to put us back on the map as far as, you know, maintaining some lives and getting to find out how to improve on this service delivery is related to on Lake Victoria. Big ups to the Ministry of Works and Transport.
Are those boats made in Uganda?
Wait.
Yeah,
I think they need to specify. They're registered in canoes.
No, they're just like every water vessel.
Every water vessel. They're doing water vessels.
We only have canoes.
No, we have ferries.
There's
a ferry from Gayaza to Kamuri. Then there's a ferry from Masaka to Karangara. Then there's a ferry from the Zisala.
Have you been on the MV? Have you been on the MV?
MV, yes. The MV,
I think, okay, that's the slightest one I can.
Mama, there's one that crosses Masaka side.
It's better?
It has life jackets.
I cannot swim. The only way you're putting me on water is if there's a helicopter flying up. I'm wearing 3 life jackets. I am pumped with some weird ish that makes me very buoyant. I am not messing around with
water transport. So
the one of Karangara. Yes.
Now you feel that one. No, I'm sorry. What?
You have been suspended until further notice. Yes, please. My brother, let us talk water transport.
I don't even understand how people of your caliber are saying that. So you were saying it's a very broke style of mind. Adam, we manna kukumiti mokulo wozambu. You have arrived when you use ebidiedi biya Kampala. I have sat on the other big ones in Dubai.
First and foremost, you don't have to swim. You can only put me on water. Helicopter.
Dubai, it was like that.
Dubai. I like the rate at which you're improving.
No, 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 no.
Very
Can
I slap the both of you and we go into a break?
But why?
Thank you. Now,
Asile Gwanga! Asile Gwanga, please, I couldn't wait for this particular
moment. My shout out is going to General, Major General Kasile Gwanga.
Hi, Daddy.
Army officer. But also, I had an issue yesterday. Was it yesterday?
Yeah, yesterday.
There was a question yesterday in Machindi. When a car that belongs to Catherine Kosasira was somewhere, and they were playing loud music, and the son to the Major General came and said, "But guy, you're making noise for us." And the guy said, "Gwe, this is a sovereign state where everyone has a right and a freedom of association." The son to Major Kasile Gwanga said, "Let me call my father, and we burn down this car."
We
burnt down the tractor that was causing a commotion on our land. This guy said, "Wapi, you can't." Before you knew it, Kasile Gwanga was out, shot a tire, and everyone went bamboozing over the society. Anyway, my shout out is that These guys were having some sort of issue with sound. Kasile Gwanga comes out, and, you know, according to Kasile Gwanga, he says, "I thought my son was under attack. That's why I shot."
Wow.
According to the guys in the car, we don't know if Catherine was in the car, but they said they have a right to play loud music.
Can I shout out now?
Hold on. If you read the law, the noise pollution law, it has a clause that categorizes hooting,
the category
loud
noise
music, you know, sirens and whatnot. It has that category.
And
and when you play loud music in jam, loud music in jam, a police officer has a right to stop you and, you know, arrest you for noise pollution.
That's true.
So whether they were right or wrong, whether Kasile Gwanga came through, came through and shot and is against the law. Of course, there's a case that's been opened
against
him. Kasile Gwanga, however, warned, and I think this that Ugandans need to take very seriously. One day, Catherine Kusasira, Ojasanga wa omunamaja atali nganzi, akube, nzesasina itande momotoka, mboneja dite kamu mutwe. That is something that we need to
We are not sure if Catherine Kusasira was on scene. That is another thing we need to note.
Well, there's an audio I listened to, and Kasile Gwanga is calling Catherine Kusasira a toad. And he's saying that one time Catherine Kusasira used his name to step out of a traffic offense.
Which means at some point maybe she was there. Friends, because how does she have his number?
No, I mean, we have people's numbers. I mean, do you know how many people
But would you just out of the blue call?
Out of the blue
There are people who can use your name because they know you and they have...
But at the end of the day, let us not to be so sure that these people have never had a relationship. You get what I'm saying?
No, I think they haven't. But you see, for me, what I learned from this story is that as much as you want to enjoy your freedom,
you need to put someone else's freedom into consideration.
Okay. You don't just buy your Kia EV. Driving next to my Range Rover. So because you can't make noise in Uganda, you start making noise and
who
going
are
around.
You?
But there now I have a right to make more noise because the car is made in Uganda. It is the first of its own very car. It's
I'm
made
a rich man.
And to be bought on Ugandan roads and to be used everywhere I want to use it. So if I play the music, you better deal with it and sell your Range Rover. That is your problem, not my problem.
Nizaku mama.
Anyway, my shout out is actually to Catherine Kusasira because yes, we are not sure if she was in the car. According to reports, yes, we saw her with police, but we were not sure if she was in the car or not in the car. My shout out, though, is not about just that. My shout out is how she showed up after the altercation. Honey, that Mickey Mouse top dress, whatever it was, I was like, okay. Now, the commentary that came out, because this is something that was really serious. Something could have gone wrong. A stray bullet could have caught someone and everything. It was... I really heated up altercation.
Already went wrong.
I know.
Because they're going to be spending 400K to repair that.
I know. Like anything could have gone wrong. But Ugandans, no one cared about their lives and how it could have gone south so fast. They were just talking about her dress, like on a Mickey Mouse, see?
It was just Mickey Mouse, see? Straight in the tire.
But then again, then again. Let's be honest. Kasile Gwanga said, you're lucky that you found omuntu mwanze. Jasango omuna majomulala ngaziva avako. Here's the situation. I love how open Kasile Gwanga is. Let's be honest. You know, he is who he is. Everybody knows he's a certain type of way. But then again, you have to ask and beg for the question. Was it right for him to do that? There was better ways to handle it. And this is not the first time that he has done things that clearly state that he's above the law. And we let him slide. Yes. And we let him slide. Listen, it was a burnt tractor. There's now bullets being fired in traffic around people. You get what I'm saying? How far do you think he's going to stretch it the next time if someone gets into his face? Change a galum.
Well, for starters.
Listen, change a galum, man. Yes, these guys fought the liberation war. Yes, they're army guys and all that stuff. This is a new, it's a new us, it's a new Uganda. I beg the authorities that are there to honestly come out and look at this because this is not the first time.
Of course, I mean, like they did mention.
Listen, it's not just him. We've had so many weird case scenarios of retired people.
Number one, there's an incident some time ago, years back, when a guy comes, pushes, tries to get close to his car, and I think pushes a hand into his car. And his dog kubes the guy.
The joke was smart. I cannot
you understand.
Hold that against him.
What the generation of today
needs to understand.
Misinterprets is the rights and freedoms they have. When someone says, I have the right of to speak.
Willis. Well, no.
Willis.
What did you say? Linda.
No, Jida.
Before you do anything about our generation and us being entitled, which is the truth, I know all of that and it's the
you
truth.
You don't know where I'm headed.
What I'm saying is, as much as we are messed up and we're entitled and we're all these things, we have to keep it in mind that someone pulled out a gun.
What I'm trying to say is this, that we forget, we try to think that rights and freedoms are absolute, and yet they are not. When you come into, you know, when you come in, for example, you're at Makindye, you're driving around and you're playing very loud music, you forget that some of us don't like your Kadongo Kamu nonsense, your band music. And
I get all of that.
Listen, so when you inconvenience us, but expect us not to inconvenience you,
But when you understand, how come it is understandable for me to pull out a gun and shoot you? But it is not understandable for me to pull out a gun and shoot you. But you as a major general should be even in a better position.
Listen. As much as we want to put the guy out to the sun and say you shouldn't pull out your gun, the first person that we should be talking about are the people. No, you're the one who's giving double standards.
No,
you're the one who's saying that the guy should not have pulled out a gun. But you're forgetting that there was a car full of young people who were making
And by the way, they were warned.
The son came out and said, "But guy, why are you shouting for us?" And they say, we have freedom, and we'll do whatever we want.
Instead of calling the police officers around, he calls the father.
The father happens to be a man. But guy, even to me, the word, there are two things. There are two things.
Guys, we're giving you enough time to talk. Let me talk. Willis, whether you want to split this in whatever different variation, the truth of the matter is, yes, the people in Catherine Kusasira's car were wrong. If you are actually, you are warned, someone comes out in good faith and they're like, yo, cool it down. They should have taken it down a notch. But then again, what you're not going to finna tell me is that it's perfectly fine for a retired major general who actually knows the law quite well to come out in broad daylight or whatever time it is into the civilian world, brandish out a gun, not just brandish out, shoot live ammunition where the civilians. That is wrong.
Listen,
I'm not saying it's right.
No, it's clearly stating that he's above the law because he has been charged.
It's not about
charged
the law.
What are the charges?
Wait.
They're not charges.
They are going to sit here. Today's Wednesday.
Do you know that he's
alone? Today's Thursday.
Do you know that?
Next week he's going to be at his place smoking cigarettes after this. Do you know that before a court of law,
there's what they call murder in self-defense?
Yes, I do know my
exactly.
Rights.
So what I'm trying to no,
yeah,
what
me,
I'm trying
to say. Get the reason
no, no, no.
Why? What harm did they do to Cassidy?
He wasn't even in the facility.
He came after the son rang him.
The son called him because they were shouting at him. By the way, please take note of what the guy said. You will be there shouting and making noise and saying it's not.
We shall not live in fear.
You will be driving your car in a very quiet neighborhood,
no,
you will make your noise.
Pollution.
A man will come out and sell for you a pit bull. It will bite you.
No, no,
you
no, no, guys, it's wrong, yes. But on the other hand, as if you had no right
to come out into civilian
and
not
shoot.
I know, but
already he's into crimes. Anything could have happened after he had shot that bull.
Let me,
he was very lucky. I wasn't moving around in my chair.
This is a catch 20.
I'm about to get into the weather forecast for this morning because as we get ready to drive around Kampala in our Chira EV, we need to know what temperature should we expect this particular morning. Here's our weather forecast. Interesting temperatures coming in, of course, in different parts of the country. Now, moving away from that, we're getting into last night online. Now, we are relating this to one of the most interesting treasures that we do have as a country and very proud of, the Kira EV. We decided to, you know, do a little bit of digging to how many African countries have actually taken an initiative to make cars by themselves. Now, apparently, research coming in is that there are six African cars made by Africans. We do have some of those on our screens right there, and we'll be reading some of them. That is the Kantanka. Yeah, Kantanka.
It's pretty though.
Yeah, it's pretty.
It's really pretty. Mm,
that's Kantanka. Made by Africans down of
that's
course.
In Ghana. That's in Ghana. I want to be Ghanaian just because that
Kantanka.
Looks.
Kantanka. Yeah.
But you see that it's just a photo representation.
Apart from the name, what is it? Isn't this like a
Captain America's star?
Apart from the name, Kantanka. I thought it was a Kantankata.
No, it's a Kantankata. I spell it out to our friends down in Ghana.
That's in Ghana.
And then, of course, that is the Inosom. That's, of course, that's
the
Mobius.
From Kenya. Yes, from Kenya. That's the Mobius from Kenya. It's like a Range Rover, though.
It looks like a Range Rover. But the thing about
the old model.
It's really, really such a hollow shell.
It looks like a vintage ride.
Like a
it's really cool.
Old
I like it.
Land Rover. It's beautiful.
I love it. I think I'd buy it. I'd buy a Mobius.
Mobius coming in from, okay, of course, Kenya. Let's see the next one.
Woo!
That's the Inson.
Inson is Nigerian. But I like it. I like
it. Perfectly represents the fact that Nigerians like to slay.
This is real slay, right?
Yeah, it's like a Range Rover. It's like a,
It wants to look like our CEO's.
It actually looks like a Kia.
Yeah.
It looks like a Kia. Down to the grill, it looks like a Kia.
Let's have the next one, please. Let's have the next one.
Inosun.
Right. Then, of course, we do have the tattoo from Ghana. And then we do have the wind and solar powered car.
Africans, help us. Mutandiko kunaming into the things that can be. I got to see the wind and solar car.
Imagine you go to a bond.
It operates on wind and solar.
Imagine you go to a bond and you guys like, so, madam, what car would you like to buy?
The wind and solar power car.
Let's get into our price gadgets for this morning. We definitely have to give you another reason as to why you do need to grab yourself a copy of the new vision. Not forgetting book at the Daily Monitor and what is happening on the international scene. A quick look at the new vision, still going for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings and 7 orders elections. This is regarding the taxes. It says issues fresh guidelines for tax operators in Uganda. Now, the detailed story is on page 5. Now, of course, they do bring you another insightful information regarding the Kasirye Gwanga incident that did happen down in Makindye. Get a full report on page 4 of the new vision. And then registration of bots that I did mention earlier on in my shout-out did commence yesterday. Now, you can get to catch up with that story as well. New law to govern election of LOP. That's, of course, leader of opposition. You get to catch up with that. President, you can discuss infrastructure development funding. Yeah, this, of course, happened down at the State House. So you get yourself a copy of the new vision and get more details regarding this particular story. We do have more news, especially on the national level, as well as some news coming in from different parts of the country in what we would like to term regional news. We do have more news coming in from the international scene and some business and tenders regarding the business pullout. Not forgetting some relationship tips right here by the love doctor himself. He says, why do women want? What do women want? This, of course, in a series form that has been published. Now, this is part 4. If you've been following out on this, today would be another day to actually catch up with that news. Not forgetting some local and international sports at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings. Quick look at the Bukede.
And of course, a quick look at the Bukede. Don't forget, Harvest Money Expo is still so on from the 15th to the 17th for only 10,000 shillings. You can come. So yeah, don't forget about that. I'll be there. All of us are going to be there. Come learn something new. Come learn how to be that farmer that's going to make you millions. We're going to help you grow money. Okay. In Bukhead Day, their biggest headline is Kusasi Asimatu Se Masasiga General Kasirye Gwanga. Gakutemipira Jamotoka. And then they go on to say Abasinia Foba Sinze Kuita Masomo Agataliga Science.
Okay.
Abakugubalaze Echase Abana Abazali Dwa Olumu Erubaga. Now yesterday I remember we were running a story about the very courageous, brave woman who actually gave birth to 6 babies at the same time. And it was a beautiful thing until midway into the day we actually found out that they had all perished, which is...
The 6?
All 6 had perished. That was not even... They didn't get to live 24 hours. It was really sad. Chivinho.
And she's so young. She's 24, man.
Yeah. I know. Anyway, and then of course, the book de KCCA is the meanwhile.
That's happening in the Daily Monitor. I'm picking a story here. UCE results to be released. Kampala senior, it's in Kampala. Senior 4 students who sat last year's final examinations will today know their fate to determine their next level of education. I know this is a time that
you leave the house, you're under pressure.
Bambi, don't be under pressure. So that's for me the biggest story in the Daily Monitor. But if you look at the international scene, we have a story from The Guardian there. And it's talking about Djibouti. There's a story in Djibouti, and they're saying scores fear dead after 2 migrant boats turned. They were overturned. And there's a route. Yeah, there's a route that usually migrants use to go to Europe and other parts of the world. And apparently, there's a disaster now on the ocean. As 2 drowned as a boat overturned. Very sad story there.
Indeed.
Right. Today you have it for some of the news. Actually, get to catch up with as the day gets to unfold in order to keep yourself acquainted with what is happening both on the local and international scene. Happen today goes in for a very short break, but when we do get back, we are flipping charts and we'll be talking everything to do with Akira EV. You definitely don't want to miss out on this.